Let us see our next chapter, triangles. In these triangles, what are the different types of the triangles based on the sides and the angles? Now, based on sides, triangles are classified into three types, that is scaling triangle, isosceles triangle, third one equilateral triangle. Equilateral triangle. Based on angles, triangles are classified into again three types. First one, acute angled triangle. Second one, obtuse angled triangle. Third one, right angled triangle. Triangle is a polygon which consists of three line segments. That is, let us see about this tree. Based on sides, that is scaling triangle ABC, a triangle in which no two sides are equal, that is all the three sides have three in different measurements, that is AB not equal to BC not equal to AC. Next, second one, isosceles triangle, that is a triangle in which any two sides are equal, is said to be an isosceles triangle. In isosceles triangle, the angles opposite to equal sides are also equal. Now, third one, in this case, we conclude that AB is equal to AC, and from these two, the common part is a A. If you remove that one, the rest one are the positions of the angles. Angle B is equal to angle C. Now, let us consider the third one, equilateral triangle. A triangle in which all the three sides are equal and all the three angles are also equal. That is, a triangle in which AB is equal to BC is equal to AC is called an equilateral triangle. And in an equilateral triangle, angle A is equal to angle B is equal to angle C is equal to 180 degrees by 3, that is each one calculates 60 degrees. Now let us come to acute angle triangle. Acute angle means which measures between 0 to 90 degrees, and 0 and 90 are not included here. That is an acute angle triangle. For example, say ABC, a triangle in which all the angles are acute. All the angles are acute, that is 50 degrees, 60 degrees, 70 degrees. 50 plus 60, that is 110, 110 plus 70, 180 degrees. A triangle in which all the three angles are acute is said to be an acute angle triangle. Secondly, a triangle in which obtuse angle triangle, that is a triangle in which one of the angles is obtuse. One of the angles is obtuse means which between 90 and 180 degrees. That means a triangle in which one of the angles is obtuse. Suppose this is a 110 degrees. Suppose this is 40 degrees. 110 plus 40, 150, the rest one is a 30 degrees. Now, right angle triangle. Right angle triangle, a triangle in which one of the angles is a right angle. That means, in right angle triangle, except right angle, other two angles are acute. Suppose, this is 30 degrees. Now, this is 60 degrees. That is, in a right angle triangle, except right angle, other two angles are acute angles. Let us see our next concept, similarity of two triangles. Similarity of two triangles. Similarity of two or more triangles, but we are considering here any two triangles. Similarity of two triangles, what is meant by similarity? That is, two triangles are said to be similar. Two triangles are said to be similar. Condition number one, corresponding angles are equal. Corresponding angles are equal. And condition number two, corresponding sides are proportional. What is meant by corresponding angles are equal and what is meant by corresponding sides are proportional? Let us see. Consider the triangle, two triangles ABC and PQR. Now, let us consider these two triangles are similar. Condition number one, corresponding angles are equal. Corresponding angles are equal means angle A is equal to angle P. Angle A equal to angle P, comma, angle B is equal to angle Q. Angle B is equal to angle Q. Next, angle C is equal to angle R. Angle C is equal to angle R. That is, two triangles are said to be similar. Condition number one is corresponding angles are equal. Number two, corresponding sides are proportional. What is meant by corresponding sides? Corresponding side of AB, that is AB by, corresponding side of AB is PQ is equal to BC by QR equal to AC by PR. That is, the ratio of AB by PQ and the ratio of BC by QR and the ratio of AC by PR must be some constant, that is equal, which is called as a proportional. Let us see, one of the important theorem of this triangles is a basic proportionality theorem. Now, see, basic proportionality theorem, which is also known as Thales theorem. Now, what is a basic proportionality theorem statement? That is, if a line drawn, parallel to one side of a triangle, If a line drawn parallel to one side of a triangle, the line divides other two sides in the same ratio. This is a statement. That is, if a line drawn parallel to one side of a triangle, the line divides the other two sides in the same ratio. That is, let us draw the diagram. ABC is a triangle, and draw a line parallel to BC. The name is DE. Now, DE is parallel to BC, and we have to show that this DE divides the other two sides in the same ratio, that is AD by DB is equal to AE by EC. That is, you have to prove. Given mainly theorem consists of the four parts. Part 1 is the given, part 2 is the RTP required to prove, part 3 is the construction, part 4 is the proof. Now, given in triangle ABC, DE is parallel to BC, that is, DE is parallel to BC. In triangle ABC, DE is parallel to BC. Now, RTP required to prove, what we have to prove in this session? The line divides the other two sides in the same ratio. That is, the line is a DE, this divides AB and AC in the same ratio. That is, to prove AD by DB is equal to AE by EC. Construction. Construction. Now, let us see. Construction. Draw DG is perpendicular to DG is perpendicular to AC, and EF is perpendicular to AB. Now, proof. Now, and one more thing in the construction, join BE and CD. Join BE and CD. Now, proof. Consider area of triangle ADE by area of triangle BDE. We have to find out the area of this one. Area of triangle we know very well, that is a half into base into height. Now consider ADE. Let us see ADE. ADE. Half into base. Base is the AD. Into height is EF. That is from triangle ADE, you consider extreme left. That is base, the right angle, the altitude stands on the which that is considered as the base, that is AD is a base and height is a EF. Now let us consider triangle BDE. Half into base, that is let us consider this part BDE, that is B D E, which is an obtuse angle. We know very well for obtuse angle altitudes will lies outside. For example, that is therefore the base is BD into height is EF. Therefore area of triangle ADE by area of triangle BDE is equal to half half get cancelled, because equal parts EF EF get cancelled. That is AD by BD, this is equation 1. Now let us see the second part, is the case 1. Similarly, consider the second part. Consider area of triangle ADE by, please consider extreme right, that is area of triangle CED, area of triangle CED, that is area of triangle ADE, area of triangle ADE half into, now you consider extreme right, base is AE into height is DG. Now let us consider CED, CED, let us consider CED, C E D, again which is an obtuse angle. For obtuse angle altitude lies outside, which is a D G. That is half into base E C into height is D G. Half into base into height, that is half half get cancelled, DG DG get cancelled. That is area of triangle ADE by area of triangle CED is equal to AE by EC. This is equation 2. See now, but triangle BDE comma triangle CED are on the same base, are on the same base. Now see, these two triangles stands on the same base DE, same base DE, and between and between same parallel lines, and between same parallel lines DE and BC, DE and BC, that is these two triangles BDE and CED are on the same base DE, and between the same parallel lines DE and BC, and between the same parallel lines DE and BC. Therefore, what we conclude from class 9th, we know well known theorem. If two triangles are on the same base and between the same parallel lines, their areas are equal. Therefore, we conclude that area of triangle BDE is equal to area of triangle CED, both are equal. Since these two triangles lie on the same base DE and between the same parallel lines. Now, from 1 and 2, numerators are same, but just now we came to know that denominators is also same. Therefore, we conclude that AD by BD is equal to AE by EC. Hence the theorem. That is RTP to prove AD by DB. AD by DB nothing but BD is equal to AE by EC. Now, after this theorem, we may know one of the important application. That is application. That is, from BPT, we know that AD by BD is equal to AE by EC. And add 1 on both sides. AD by BD plus 1 is equal to AE by EC plus 1. Now, LCM AD plus DB by BD is equal to AE plus EC by EC. That is AD plus BD into 1 BD or DB by BD is equal to, similarly, LCM is a EC, AE plus EC into 1 EC. That is AD plus DB. From the diagram, AD plus DB, that is equal to AB by BD. That is equal to, next, AE plus EC, AE plus EC, that is nothing but AC by EC. That is what we understand from this one is total by part. That is the total part is AB and other part AC by EC. Now, application 2. Let us see the application 2. From BPT, from basic proportionality theorem, we know that AD by DB is equal to AE by EC. That is, please make the reciprocal of this one, which becomes BD by AD is equal to CE by AE. Now, after that, adding 1 to left, that is 1 plus BD by AD is equal to 1 plus CE by AE. That is AD plus BD by AD is equal to AE plus CE by AE. That is AD plus BD. AD plus BD, which gives you AB by AD is equal to AE plus CE, AE plus CE, which gives you AC by AE. This is the second application. That is, application one is the total by first part BD, this part. Here AB by AD, upper part. That means whether you consider total by part or part by total or part by total, BPT theorem will be true. Let us see the next theorem, basic proportionality theorem, just we discussed. Now we have to discuss with the converse of basic proportionality theorem. That is, meaning of the converse is, without changing the meaning, you have to write from backward. Now, statement. If a line divides any two sides of a triangle, if a line divides any two sides of a triangle in the same ratio, in the same ratio, then the line is, then the line is parallel to the third side. Then the line is parallel to the third side. This is the statement of converse basic proportionality theorem. Once recall basic proportionality theorem. If a line divides any two sides of a triangle in the same ratio, then the line is parallel to the third side. Now, what is the statement of basic proportionality theorem? If in a triangle, if a line drawn parallel to one side of a triangle, which divides the other two sides in the same ratio. Now, let us draw the diagram. ABC. Given in triangle ABC, in triangle ABC, the line DE intersect AB at D, comma AC at E, such that AD by DB is equal to AE by EC. That is, next RTP. What you have to show? Now, to prove DE is parallel to BC, we have to prove DE is parallel to BC. Now, construction draw DF parallel to BC. Draw DF parallel to BC. Now come to proof. Now let us assume that DE is not parallel to BC. Now you have to assume that DE is not parallel to BC. That is, DE is not parallel to BC. Then there exist a point F on AC such that DF parallel to BC. What is our imagination? Let us assume that DE is not parallel to BC. DE is not parallel to BC. But according to the BPT theorem, one line must be parallel to the other side. Then there exists a point F on AC such that DF is parallel to BC. Now that is from BPT. AD by DB is equal to AF by FC. From BPT. Now this is equation 1. Now this is equation 2. Now from 1 and 2. AD by DB, that is LHS are equal. Now equate the RHS. That is AE by EC is equal to AF by FC. That is, now AE by EC is equal to AF by FC. Now let us see, AE by EC is equal to AF by FC. Now adding 1 on both sides, AE by EC plus 1 is equal to AF by FC plus 1. That is, AE plus EC by EC is equal to AF plus FC by FC. Now let us see, AE plus EC, go to the diagram, AE plus EC, which will gives you AC by EC. That is equal to AF plus FC, which will gives you again AC by FC. Numerators are same, eliminate on both sides. Now 1 by EC is equal to 1 by FC. Now here numerators are again same and denominators are also, C is the common and E and F are the different, which is possible. That is, this implies numerators are same means we can write as EC is equal to FC. That is, from the diagram, EC and FC will be equal, never. That is, which is possible, only when E and F are coincide each other. Coincide each other. Therefore, what is our imagination? Let us assume that DE is not parallel to BC. Therefore, we conclude that DE is a parallel to BC. Hence proved. Let us see the next theorem. Vertical angle bisector theorem. Vertical angle bisector theorem. That is, the vertical angle of a triangle, the bisector of the vertical angle divides the base in the ratio of other two sides. This is the statement of the theorem. The bisector of the vertical angle of a triangle divides the base in the ratio of other two sides. Now, let us see the diagram. A, B, C. Now, bisector of the vertical angle. Angle A is bisected and AD is the bisector of angle A. Now, given in triangle ABC, AD is the bisector of angle A. AD is the bisector of angle A. RTP, the bisector of the vertical angle divides the base in the ratio of other two sides. That is, to prove AB by AC is equal to BD by DC. We have to prove this one. Construction. In some questions, the given information is not sufficient to prove the theorem. In such cases, we have to add some additional angles and sides. Such parts are included in the construction. Now, let us see. Now, produce, this is the construction part. In this construction part, AB is produced up to E such that C touches the E. Construction, draw CE parallel to BA, CE parallel to DA, such that CE, draw CE parallel to AD or DA, such that BA produced to meet at E, to meet CE at E. This is the construction. Now here, this is the 1, this is the 2. Here angle 3, here angle 4. Now, proof. Since AD is the bisector, AD is the bisector of angle A, then we conclude that angle 1 is equal to angle 2. These two are equal. Next, AD is parallel to CE. AD is parallel to, see, these two are parallel, and AC is the transversal. AC is the transversal. Then angle 2 is equal to angle 3. Angle 2 is equal to angle 3. Reason: alternate interior angles. Alternate interior angles. Similarly, angle 1 is equal to angle 4. Angle 1 and angle 4 are equal, since these two are corresponding angles. Now, angle 1 is equal to angle 2. This is equation 1. Angle 2 is equal to angle 3. This is equation 2. This is equation 3. Now, from 1, 2 and 3, from 1, 2 and 3, 2, 2 equal, that is angle 1 is equal to angle 3, angle 1 is equal to angle 3, but angle 1 is equal to angle 4, that is in place of, that is angle 4 is equal to angle 3, since angle 1 is equal to angle 4. Angle 1 and 4 are equal. Now angle 1 is replaced with angle 4. Now angle 3 and angle 4 are equal. That is, the side opposite to angle 3 is AE is equal to AE, and the side opposite to angle 4 is AC. AE is equal to AC. Therefore, here we conclude that from triangle ACE, take that ACE out. ACE. AE equal to AC. AE and AC is equal. A triangle in which any two sides are equal, then it is called as an isosceles triangle. In isosceles triangle, the angles opposite to equal sides are also equal. That is, here I got that AE is equal to AC, therefore triangle ACE is an isosceles triangle. Therefore, triangle ACE is an isosceles triangle. Now, let us consider another part. That is, from triangle BEC, BEC, from triangle BEC, let us consider BEC, BEC, AD is parallel to CE, AD is parallel to CE, that is AD is parallel. AD is parallel. AD is parallel. That is DE. Replace D here and E here. Sorry, this is A. Now, from BPT, from basic proportionality theorem, BA by AE is equal to BD by DC, which can be write as AB by AE is equal to BD by DC. Now, since AD by AE nothing but AC is equal to BD by DC, hence the theorem. What we have to prove? AB by AC, AB by AC, this can be read as AB, AB by AC is equal to BD by DC, hence proved. Let us see the next theorem. Ratio of areas of two similar triangles. Statement: the ratio of areas of two similar triangles is equal to ratio of squares of corresponding sides. Ratio of areas of two similar triangles is equal to ratio of squares of corresponding sides. Now, given triangle ABC, comma triangle PQR are two similar triangles. Triangle ABC, comma triangle PQR are two similar triangles. Let us consider triangle ABC triangle PQR. are two similar triangles. RTP, what we have to prove? To prove area of triangle ABC by area of triangle PQR is equal to ratio of squares of corresponding sides, that is AB square by AB corresponding side is PQ square is equal to BC square by BC corresponding QR square and AC square, AC corresponding side is PR square. This is what we have to prove. Now, construction draw AD perpendicular to BC and PS comma PS perpendicular to QR. Now proof: triangle ABC is similar to triangle PQR. Two triangles are said to be similar. The condition number one, their corresponding angles are equal. Condition number two, their corresponding sides are proportional. That is AB by PQ is equal to BC by QR equal to AC by PR and angle A equal to angle P comma angle B equal to angle Q comma angle C equal to angle R. According to the similarity conditions, corresponding sides are proportional and corresponding angles are equal. Now consider area of triangle ABC is equal to half into from triangle ABC, base is a BC into height is a AD, equation 1. Now again area of triangle PQR equal to half into base is the QR into height is the PS. This is equation 2. Now equation 1 divided by equation 2. Area of triangle ABC by area of triangle PQR is equal to half into BC into AD by half into QR into PS. That is half get cancelled. Therefore, area of triangle ABC by area of triangle PQR equal to BC into AD by QR into PS, which is equation 1. Now, from triangle ABD, comma, from triangle PQS, let us take these two triangles out. Let us consider these two triangles. Angle B is equal to angle Q. Angle B is equal to angle Q. Corresponding angles. And angle ADB, is equal to angle PSQ is equal to 90 degrees each. Therefore, triangle ABD is congruent, corresponding, similar to triangle PQS. Reason, angle similarity. That is, from this we can write that these two are similar. AB by PQ is equal to AD by PS. This is equation 2. Since triangle ABD, comma, triangle PQS, or else simply you can write from BPT, from basic proportionality theorem. Now substitute equation 2 in equation 1. That is, area of triangle ABC by area of triangle PQR is equal to BC by QR into AD by PS. Continue. BC by QR is equal to AD by PS. That is equal to BC by QR into AD by PS. AD by PS nothing but AB by PQ. That is, area of triangle ABC by area of triangle PQR is equal to BC by QR into AB by PQ nothing but BC by QR. That is equal to BC square by QR square. That is, area of triangle, what RTP we have to prove? Area of triangle ABC by area of triangle PQR is equal to BC square by QR square. That is, similarly we can prove, area of triangle ABC by area of triangle PQR is equal to AB square by PQ square comma area of triangle ABC by area of triangle PQR is equal to AC square by PR square. Therefore, area of triangle ABC by area of triangle PQR is equal to all the three parts AB square by PQ square is equal to BC square by QR square is equal to AC square by PR square. Hence the theorem. Therefore, from this theorem, we understand that the ratio of areas of two similar triangles is equal to ratio of squares of corresponding sides. Let us see the next theorem. Ratio of areas of two similar triangles. The ratio of areas of two similar triangles is equal to ratio of squares of corresponding altitudes. That is, given triangle ABC, comma triangle PQR, triangle ABC, comma triangle PQR are two similar triangles. RTP to prove area of triangle ABC by area of triangle PQR is equal to ratio of squares of corresponding altitudes. That is, AD is the altitude of triangle ABC and PS is the altitude of triangle PQR is equal to, we have to prove AD square by PS square. That is, we have to prove. Now, construction, no need of any construction. Now we have to go directly with the proof. Now, since triangle ABC is similar to triangle PQR, then we know that area of triangle ABC by area of triangle PQR is equal to AB square by PQ square, BC square by QR square and AC square by PR square. Because we know this theorem very well, ratio of areas of two similar triangles is equals to ratio of squares of corresponding sides. Now in this theorem we have to prove ratio of squares of corresponding altitudes. Now from triangle from triangle, ABD, comma, from triangle PQS. Let us consider these two triangles. That is A, right angle is at D, B. Similarly, in the second one, right angle is at S, P, S, Q. We know very well, that is angle B is equal to angle Q. Since these two are corresponding angles, of a similar triangles are equal. Now, and angle D, which can be written as angle A, D, B is equal to angle P, S, Q is equal to 90 degrees. Therefore, these two triangles are said to be similar. Therefore, triangle ABD is similar to triangle PQS. Reason, angle-angle similarity. By angle-angle similarity, these two are equal. That is, after that, in similar triangles, by BPT, we can write that AB by PQ, is equal to AD by PS. This is equation 2, this is equation 1. Now, substitute equation 2 in equation 1. That is, area of triangle ABC by area of triangle PQR is equal to, now after this one, squaring on both sides, this part I can write as AB square by PQ square is equal to AD square by PS square I can write. That is after squaring. That is, from triangle you can choose any one of them. That is AB square by PQ square. Now, area of triangle ABC by area of triangle PQR is equal to AB square by PQ square, nothing but AD square by PS square. Therefore, ratio of areas of two similar triangles is equal to ratio of squares of corresponding sides. This is one part is completed. Now, let us come to second part, part 2. Now, let us consider triangle ADC, comma, triangle PSR. Let us consider these two triangles and take out. That is, right angle is at D and right angle is at S. This is ADC, this is PSR. Now, from this triangle, from these two triangles, I conclude that angle C is equal to angle R. Reason, corresponding angles. Corresponding angles. And angle ADC is equal to angle PSR. Angle PSR, reason 90 degrees. Therefore, these two triangles are said to be, that is, triangle ADC is similar to triangle PSR. Reason, angle-angle similarity. By angle-angle similarity, these two are similar. Now, from this, what I conclude that AC by PR is equal to AC by PR is equal to AD by PS. Now, this implies squaring on both sides. AC square by PR square is equal to AD square by PS square. Now, this is equation 3. Substitute equation 3 in equation 1. That is, equation 1, area of triangle ABC by area of triangle PQR is equal to, now you can consider any of the part, now we will consider the part 3, that is AC square by PR square. Now therefore, area of triangle ABC by area of triangle PQR is equal to AC square by PR square, nothing but AD square by PS square. Therefore, ratio of areas of two similar triangles is equals to ratio of squares of corresponding altitudes. Now, part 2 is completed. Similarly, we can prove part 3, that is area of triangle ABC by area of triangle PQR is equal to BC square by QR square. Let us see the next theorem. The ratio of areas of two similar triangles. The ratio of areas of two similar triangles is equals to ratio of squares of corresponding medians. That is, given. Now let us consider two triangles. Triangle ABC and triangle PQR are two similar triangles, and AD is a median and PS is a median. Now triangle ABC is similar to triangle PQR, are two similar triangles, are two similar triangles. Now, two similar triangles means we can write here angle A is equal to angle P, angle B is equal to angle Q, angle C is equal to angle R. And similarly, we can write AB by PQ is equal to BC by QR equal to AC by PR, since these two triangles are similar. RTP, to prove area of triangle ABC by area of triangle PQR is equal to ratio of areas of two similar triangles is equal to ratio of squares of corresponding medians, that is median AD square by PS square. We have to prove this one. Now, proof. We know that area of triangle ABC by area of triangle PQR is equal to AB square by PQ square is equal to BC square by QR square is equal to AC square by PR square. This is we know from our previous knowledge. Now, since AD is a median, the line segment joining from vertex to midpoint of its opposite side is called as a median. And these two parts are equal, since D is the midpoint of BC. Similarly, these two parts are also equal, since S is the midpoint of QR. Now, consider, now this is equation 1. From triangle ABD, comma, from triangle PQS, take these two triangles out. ABD and PQS. Now, let us see. From these two triangles, angle B is equal to angle Q. Angle B is equal to angle Q. And one more thing, before going to prove this one, we have to consider the corresponding sides. AB by from this triangle, AB by PQ is equal to BC by QR, and BC nothing but 2 times of BD. Why? Because BD is equal to DC. Similarly, QR is nothing but 2 times of QS. That is, therefore, AB by PQ is equal to 2 to get cancelled, BD by QS. BD by QS. And this is equation 2. Now AB by PQ is equal to BD by QS. Therefore, triangle and angle B is equal to angle Q, since it is corresponding angles. Therefore, triangle ABD is similar to triangle PQS. Reason: side angle, side similarity. Side angle, side. AB by PQ is the one side. Next, BD by QS is another side, and including angle. Therefore, by SAS similarity, these two are similar. Since triangle ABD and triangle PQS are similar, therefore, we can write as AB by PQ is equal to AD by PS. Now, the same part you can squaring on both sides, that is AB square by PQ square is equal to AD square by PS square. Now, this is equation 3. Substitute equation 3 in equation 1. That is area of triangle ABC by area of triangle PQR is equal to AB square by PQ square. But from the previous step, AB square by PQ square is equals to AD square by PS square. Therefore, area of triangle ABC by area of triangle PQR is equal to AD square by PS square. Hence the theorem. Therefore, ratio of areas of two similar triangles is equal to ratio of squares of corresponding medians. Let us see the next theorem, Pythagoras theorem. Now we will discuss with the Pythagoras theorem. Let us come to the statement. In a right triangle, the square of the hypotenuse, the square of the hypotenuse is equal to sum of squares of other two sides. In a right triangle, the square of the hypotenuse is equal to sum of squares of other two sides. Now, let us consider a triangle ABC. Right angle is at B. Let us consider a triangle ABC and right angle is at B. Given in triangle ABC, in triangle ABC, right angle is at B. Right angle is at B. RTP, to prove right angle opposite side is the hypotenuse, that is hypotenuse square AC square equal to AB square plus BC square. Construction, construction, draw BD is perpendicular to AC. Draw BD is perpendicular to AC. Now proof. In triangle ABC, right angle is at B. In triangle ABC, right angle is at BD divides, BD divides triangle ABC into two right angles, two right triangles, triangle BDC, comma triangle ADB. Now consider, two right triangles. Names, triangle 1, triangle 2. This is triangle ABC. First part and the second part. Consider the first part. In the first part, right angle is at D. ADB. Now consider triangle ADB, comma triangle ABC. Angle A equal to angle A. Reason, common angle, and angle ADB is equal to angle ABC equal to 90 degrees. Therefore, triangle ADB is similar to triangle ABC by angle-angle similarity. By angle-angle similarity, these two triangles are similar. Now, from these two triangles, compare AB by AC is equal to AD by AB. Since these two triangles are similar, in similar triangles corresponding sides are proportional. That is, AB square is equal to AC into AD. This is equation 1. Next, consider triangles. Again, consider the two triangles. Again, consider the two triangles. Big triangle name is ABC and right angle is at B. ABC. Now, let us consider the down triangle part 2, where the right angle is at D. Second triangle name is BDC. Now, consider the triangle BDC, comma, triangle ABC. Now, angle C is equal to angle C, reason, common angle. And angle BDC is equal to angle ABC, equal to 90 degrees. Therefore, triangle ABC is similar to triangle BDC by angle similarity. Now, since these two triangles are congruent, now compare the sides. BC by AC is equal to BC by AC is equal to CD by BC. CD by BC. Now, cross multiply. BC square is equal to AC into CD. This is equation 2. Now, equation 1 plus equation 2. Equation 1, AB square plus BC square is equal to AC into AD plus AC into CD from equation 2. Now, AB square plus BC square is equal to AC, take common, AD plus CD, that is AB square plus BC square is equal to AC into AD plus CD from the diagram, AD plus CD, which will gives you AC. Therefore, AB square plus BC square is equal to AC into AC, AC square. Therefore, AC is a hypotenuse. Therefore, we conclude that in a right angle triangle, the square of the hypotenuse is equal to sum of squares of other two sides. Hence the theorem. Let us see the next theorem, converse of Pythagoras theorem. Converse of Pythagoras theorem. The square of one side of a triangle is equal to sum of squares of sum of squares of other two sides, then the angle opposite to, then the angle opposite to first side is a right angle. This we have to prove now. The square of one side of a triangle is equal to sum of squares of other two sides. Then the angle opposite to first side is a right angle. Now, given, let us draw the diagram first. Consider the triangle ABC. ABC. That is, in triangle ABC, AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. The square of one side of a triangle is equals to sum of squares of other two sides. Then the angle opposite to the first side. Now first side is AC. The angle opposite to this one is B. This one you have to show. This one you have to show right angle. Now RTP, to prove angle B equal to 90 degrees. Now let us consider another right angle triangle name DEF. Right angle is at E, such that AB DE is equal to AB and EF is equal to BC. We have to construct it an angle. Construction Consider a right triangle. Consider a right triangle DEF such that right angle is at angle E equal to 90 degrees. Consider a right triangle DEF where angle E equal to 90 degrees such that DE is equal to AB and EF is equal to BC. In such a way you have to construct a right triangle DEF. Now proof. Now, from triangle DEF, right angle at E, we can write DF square is equal to DE square plus EF square by Pythagoras theorem. In Pythagoras theorem, the square of the hypotenuse is equals to sum of squares of other two sides. Now DF square is equal to DE nothing but AB square, EF nothing but BC, BC square. That is DF square is equal to, from equation 1, AB square plus BC square nothing but AC square. Cancel the squares on both sides, DF is equal to AC. Now, let us consider these two triangles. Now, triangle DEF and triangle ABC. DE is equal to AB since these two are equal, and EF is equal to BC. Reason for these two is construction. In the construction, we suppose that DE is equal to AB and EF is equal to BC, and DF is equal to AC. Just now we proved this one. Therefore, from these three points we conclude that triangle DEF is congruent to triangle ABC. Reason, side congruency. By side congruency, these two are congruent. In congruent triangles, corresponding parts are equal. What are the corresponding parts? Angle D is equal to, angle D is equal to angle A, angle F is equal to angle C, and angle D is equal to angle B. Reason, CPCT, corresponding parts of congruent triangles. Therefore, by SSS congruency, these two triangles are congruent. In congruent triangles, corresponding parts are equal. Angle D equal to angle A, angle F is equal to angle C, and angle E equal to angle E equal to angle E equal to angle B. Therefore, angle B is equal to angle E, but angle E is equal to 90 degrees. Therefore, we conclude that angle B is equal to 90 degrees. Therefore, the square of one side of a triangle is equal to sum of squares of other two sides of, then the angle opposite to first side is a right angle. Therefore, angle B equal to 90, hence the theorem. Let us see the next theorem, acute angle theorem. Acute angle theorem, that is, let us draw the diagram first. In triangle ABC, angle B is acute, and AD is perpendicular to BC. Then prove that in triangle ABC, angle B is acute. Angle B is acute angle, and AD is perpendicular to, AD is perpendicular to BC. AD is perpendicular to BC, then prove that, AC square equal to AB square plus BC square minus 2BC into BD. This is you have to prove. Now, given in triangle ABC, angle B is acute. Acute means we know the angle which represents below 90 degrees, and AD perpendicular to BC. Now, proof. Now, from triangle ABD, right angle is at D, that is angle AD, angle ADB equal to 90 degrees. Next, take the triangle out. Triangle ADB, angle B is acute. We can write AB square equal to, AB square is equal to AD square plus BD square. This is equation 1 from Pythagoras theorem. Now, again consider another triangle. Now, from triangle, another right angle triangle ACD, right angle at angle ADC equal to 90 degrees. Now, AC square equal to, now let us take A, D, C. Now let us say AC square equal to, AD square plus CD square. Now, this is equation 2. Now let us simplify this one. AC square is equal to AD square plus the value of CD. How to get the value of CD is BC minus, from BC you have to subtract BD. BC minus BD will give you, from BC you subtract BD, you will get the value of CD whole square. Now AC square is equal to AD square plus, this is A minus B whole square form, that is BC square plus BD square minus 2 into BC into BD. That is A minus B whole square, A square plus B square minus 2AB. Now, AC square equal to AD square plus BD square plus BC square minus 2 into BC into BD. Now from equation 1, AC square is equal to AD square plus BD square. AD square plus BD square, nothing but AB square plus BC square minus 2 into BC into BD. Now see, AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square minus 2BC into BD. Hence the theorem. Let us see the next theorem, obtuse angle theorem. Obtuse angle theorem. In triangle ABC, angle B is obtuse. Angle B is obtuse and AD is perpendicular to CB produced. Then prove that AC square equal to AB square plus BC square plus 2BC into BD. Now follow the diagram. A, D, B, C. Obtuse angle is at B and AD is perpendicular to CB produced. Then we have to prove AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square plus 2BC into BD. Given in triangle ABC, angle B is obtuse and AD is perpendicular to CB. Now proof. From triangle ABD, from triangle ABD, right angle at D, right angle at D, that is angle D equal to 90 degrees. Take the diagram out. A, D, B, that is from the diagram AB square is equal to AD square plus BD square, equation 1 from Pythagoras theorem, which is equation 1. Now again from triangle ADC, from triangle ADC, right angle at D, angle D equal to 90 degrees. Now consider this triangle ADC in between a point B. Now AC square is equal to AD square plus CD square. Other side. Now from Pythagoras theorem. Now AC square equal to AD square plus CD, nothing but BD plus BC, that is BD plus BC whole square. Now AC square is equal to AD square plus, this is of the form A plus B whole square, that is A square plus B square plus 2 into A into B. Now AC square is equal to AD square plus BD square, AD square plus BD square plus BC square plus 2 into BD into BC. That is, we will write BC into BD. Now AC square is equal to AD square plus BD square from 1, which will gives you AB square plus BC square plus 2 into BC into BD, write in terms of bracket. Since AD square plus BD square is equal to AB square, therefore AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square plus 2 into BC into BD. Hence the theorem. Let us see the next examples. Use bisector theorem and find the missing values of the sides of triangle ABC. Now here three questions are given. These three questions are three different in models. Now ABC, this is considered as D. Now answer to question number 1. From triangle ABC, the bisector of angle A divides the base in the ratio of other two sides. That means you can write as AB by AC is equal to AB by AC is equal to BD by CD. Now let us consider this is the X. Now this is 12 minus X from the diagram. Now substitute the values. AB value 10 by 6 is equal to BD value is X by CD value is 12 minus X. Now cross multiply. 6X is equal to 10 into 12 minus X. Now 2 table 3 times 3X is equal to 5 times 12 minus X. That is 3X is equal to 60 minus 5X. That is 3x plus 5x is equal to 60, 8x is equal to 60, and x is equal to 60 by 8. 60 by 8, that is 8 table 60. Let us see 2 table, or else 8 table 60. That is X is equal to 7.5 centimeters. Now X is 7.5 centimeters. Now we have to find the value of y, that is y is equal to 12 minus x. Y is equal to 12 minus 7.5, that is y is equal to 4.5 centimeters. Therefore, the value of x is 7.5 and the value of y is 4.5 from the first question. Now, let us come to second question. From triangle ABC, the vertical angle is A, which is a bisected. Therefore, by the theorem, AB by AC is equal to BD by DC. That is, AB value is 4 by 5.2 is equal to BD value 3 by X. Now, cross multiply, 4x is equal to 3 into 5.2. That is, 4x is equal to 52, 3 is 6, 156. Point after one decimal place. Now, x is equal to 15.6 by 4. Now, x is equal to 4 table, 3 times 12. Remainder is 3, 36, 9 times, that is 3.9 times. That is, x value is 3.9 centimeters. Now, I have to find the value of the BC. BC is equal to BD plus DC. That is, BC is equal to BD value is 3 plus 3.9. Therefore, BC is equal to 6.9 centimeters. Now, let us come to third example. From triangle ABC, AB by AC is equal to BD by DC. Now, AB value 5.6, by AC value we have to find out. BD value is 3.2 centimeters, by the total value of BC is 6 centimeters, that is 6 minus 3.2, that is 5.6 by AC is equal to, here 3.2 by 2.8, that is 5.6 by AC is equal to 32 by 28, because point after one decimal place in the numerator and the denominator also point after one decimal place, therefore decimals are balanced. Now, fourth table, 6 fours are, now 7 fours are, 8 fours are, that is, again 8 table, this is 0.7 times. Now, the required part is 0.7 by AC is equal to 1 by 7. That is, AC is equal to 0.7 into 7. That is, AC is equal to 49. Now, decimal one place after. Therefore, the value of AC is 4.9 centimeters. Let us see the next examples. In triangle ABC, DE parallel to BC. Then find the missing values. Now, answer to the first one. In triangle ABC, DE is parallel to BC. Now, from BPT, from basic proportionality theorem, Here part is given, here also part is given, other side part is given, and again asking the rest of the part. Then we have to use part by part. From BPT, AD by DB is equal to AE by EC. Now AD 1.5 by 3 is equal to 1 by X. That is cross multiply, 1.5 into X is equal to 3 and X is equal to 3 by 1.5. That is X is equal to, for our convenient use, 10 by 10 to convert a decimal to the number. That is 30 by using point of 10, 1.5 becomes 15, therefore X is equal to 2. Now therefore the value of X is equal to 2. Similarly, we'll come to the second one. From triangle ABC, DE is parallel to BC. Therefore, from BPT, from basic proportionality theorem, we can write AD by DB is equal to AE by EC. And in this question, you have to find out the value of AB is also. Now, AD value Y by 7.2 is equal to AE 1.8 by EC value 5.4. Now, Y by 7.2 is equal to 18 by 54 because in the numerator and denominator, the number of decimal places are the same. Now, Y by 7.2 is equal to 18 table. This is the 3 times. Now, cross multiply. Y is equal to 7.2 by 3. That is, Y is equal to 2.23 are 6. Remainder is the 1. After 2, that is a 12. 2.4 centimeters. Therefore, the value of Y is 2.4 centimeters. Now, I need to find the value of AB. AB is equal to AD plus BD. That is, AB is equal to AD nothing but Y. Y value is 2.4 plus 7.2. That is, AB is equal to 9.6 centimeters. Therefore, the value of AB is equal to 9.6 centimeters.